Right, so what we're going to talk about now is setting the fire. So, as you see on the video, I've been walking around with dry grass in my pocket. So, as I've been on the move over Dartmoor, I've been picking up bits of gnawed grass and bits of dry grass. And I've put it into a little bundle, been carrying it in my pocket, hopefully to dry it out. But when you're lighting a fire, there's a couple of things you need. And that's tinder, kindling and fuel. At the minute, all I've got is tinder here, because I'm just showing you a quick demonstration. But I want bundles of it. So, if I'm staying here permanently now, I need a lot of kindling, a lot of fuel. I need more logs. Alright, and build up and build up. But I'm just going to show you a quick demonstration. So I've been walking around with this dry grass in my pocket. Well, this sort of damp grass is starting to dry out. Walking around that in my pocket. Other things I carry on me as well. So a bit of cotton wool and a bit of char cloth. How you make char cloth, right, is get the old towels. Well, you can buy from any pound store. Cotton ones. Put them in a metal tin. Put a hole in the tin and just cook it over a fire. And what you do is char it like it is here, nice and brittle it is, and any spark what goes in that, it's going to burn for a long time. But anyway, here's we are now. I've made my nest. I'm going to get a bit of cotton wool in there. Then I'm going to get my char cloth in there. And all I want is a spark on it, like so. 45 to the angle. And what a lot of people do when they're using flint and steel, they push forward. What you want to do, you want to pull back, because when you're making your nest or you're making a little tinder bundle, you push forward, you're not hitting everywhere, so you want to pull backwards like so. And as you can see now, it's starting to burn. And all I'm going to do is... And that is it. And what you do then is just build up, build up, build up. Bigger logs, bigger logs, bigger logs. But that's enough tinder there to get a fire going. And it's simple as that. And what this is going to do then is it's going to help me cook food. It's going to help me purify water. And it's going to keep animals away. And that is it really. But that's a quick and simple method to start a fire. And using some of the resources we picked up from the ground. So thank you very much.